The living word. As we all know, this world is a wonderful place with a variety of organisms, maybe living and non-living. First of all, as the chapter says, living word, we need to know when to call an organism living, what are its defining characters. Living organism exhibits growth, reproduction, consciousness, metabolism, and many more. But all these are not at all the defining character of an organism, especially living organism. So let's study one by one. First, growth. It can simply define as increase in mass and number of individuals. In plants, the cell divides throughout its life, and in animals only till certain age. Hence, it is not at all the defining character of an organism. Second one, reproduction. Reproduction is a process of producing young ones of their own kind. For unicellular organisms, cell division itself is a mode of reproduction. Here's some example. Yeast and Hydra reproduce by budding, Planaria by regeneration, and it is not the defining character of an organism. Third one, metabolism. All the chemical reactions occurring in our body is called as metabolism. No non-living organisms can exhibit metabolism. Hence, it is a defining character. And the next one is consciousness. It is also a defining property of a living organism. Mainly, we humans are self-conscious. That is, who is aware of himself. And this is the defining property. Along with that, cellular organization is also a defining property of a living organism. There is a one more important point in a para, that is, photo period affects reproduction in seasonal breeders. What are seasonal breeders? You are going to learn about the seasonal breeders in first chapter of class 12th. Biodiversity. Earth has millions of species. Biodiversity refers to the number and types of organisms present on this earth. Organisms belong to different categories, and these categories are called as taxa. And for example, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Species is the smallest unit or taxon. The species includes individuals that interbreed and produce offsprings. The chromosome number is fixed in species. Now the term taxonomy. Based on the characteristics of all the living organisms, it is classified into different taxa. This process of classification is called as taxonomy. Classification is a process by which anything is grouped into categories based on characters. Since there were binomial nomenclature, this is the system of providing names to an organism with two components. For example, Mangifera indica. This is the scientific name of mango. The first word Mangifera indicates generic name, and the second word indica represents specific epithet. Carolus Linnaeus introduced the system of binomial nomenclature. There are a few rules in this binomial nomenclature, and the first rule is biological names are generally in Latin and written in italics. There are Latinized or derived from Latin irrespective of their origin. And the second rule is The first word in the biological name represents the genus, while the second component denotes the specific epithet. Third rule is, both the words in the biological name, when handwritten, are separately underlined or printed in italics to indicate their Latin origin. The first word denoting the genus starts with the capital letter, while the specific epithet starts with the small letter. The next term is systematics. The study which deals with the different varieties of organisms and the relationship among them is called systematics. Let us study one by one. Now, species. This is the smallest unit of taxonomy. Many individuals having similar characters, same number of chromosomes, and ability to interbreed belong to the same species. Many related species belong to same genus. Now, genus. Genus includes many related species. For example, Solanum nigrum, which is a wild brinjal, Solanum melangena, brinjal, Solanum lycopersicum, which is tomato, Solanum tuberosum, which is potato. And this next example is Panthera leo, which is lion, Panthera tigris, which is tiger, Panthera pardus is leopard. In the first example, all the vegetables belong to the genus Solanum, and in the second example, all the animals belong to the genus Panthera. And the next classification is family. Family includes many related genera or genus. For example, Solanaceae. In the family Solanaceae, we include tomato, potato, brinjal, datura, and many more. The next is order. Order includes many related families which has similar morphological characters. For example, primata, carnivora, diptera, poales. Family Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae belong to order Polymoniales, and families such as Canidae and Felidae are included in the order Carnivora. The next classification is class. Class includes many related orders. For example, orders Carnivora and Primata are included in the single class called Mammalia. Next, phylum, which includes related classes. Classes such as Mammalia, apes, Reptalia, Amphibia, and more come under phylum Chordata. And the last and the largest classification is kingdom. It includes many related phylum. For example, phyla such as Chordata, Arthropoda, etc. are included under kingdom Animalia. The next important topic is taxonomical aids. Organisms are identified and classified into different taxa based on several characters. And the following taxonomical aids are useful in the identification and classification of unknown organisms. The first taxonomical aid is botanical garden. These are the collection of living plant species. Botanists maintain different species of plants along with complete taxonomical details. These plants become useful reference for the identification of unknown plants. Examples for famous botanical gardens are Kew in England, National Botanical Research Institution in Lucknow, Indian Botanical Garden in Howrah. The second taxonomical aid is herbaria. It is a storehouse of collected plant specimens which are dried, pressed and preserved on sheets. These sheets are arranged according to taxonomic categories. These sheets become useful reference materials for the identification of newly collected plants. Each herbarium sheet provides following information: date of collection, date of place of collection, collector's name, scientific name of plant, common name, family name. And the third taxonomic aid is museum. This is the collection of preserved plant and animals for studies and reference. Specimens of preserved in formalin or dilute alcohol. Some animals such as insects can be preserved by killing and pinning method. Larger animals like birds and mammals are stuffed and preserved. We can also keep skeleton of animals for future reference. The fourth taxonomical aid is zoological park. This is the collection of wild animals. Zoological parks are useful in conservation of endangered species. It also helps us to study the animal behavior and create awareness about wildlife. Next one, keys. These are the taxonomical aids used in the identification of plants and animal species based on the similarity and dissimilarity. The keys are based on the contrasting characters generally in pair called as couplet. It represents the choice between two opposite options. This results in acceptance of only one and rejection of the other. Each statement in the key is called as lead. The next is monograph. This is the taxonomical aid which contains information on any one taxon. The next is manuals. These are the taxonomical aid which provide information for the identification of names or species found in an area. The next is flora. This is the taxonomical aid which contains details of plants along with habit and their distribution. And the last one is catalogs, which provide complete information of species arranged in alphabetic order. Here completes the lesson, Living Word. Thank you.